Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday or Saturday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX successfully launched their 79th mission of the year with Starlink 626.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1058, then landed successfully for the 18th time, becoming the first to do so on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch more Falcon 9 missions launch. The next Falcon 9 launch is the Transporter 9 mission, currently scheduled for Wednesday 8th at 4 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 7th at 11 p.m. EST. Following that, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 627 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 9th at 6:47 p.m. UTC or 1:47 p.m. EST. Then, later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see a Dragon mission. The CRS-29 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 10th at 1:28 a.m. UTC or Thursday 9th at 9:28 p.m. EST. A little later in the week, we could expect to see another Falcon 9 mission launch as well. The O3B M-Power 5 and 6 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 12th at 9:08 p.m. UTC or 4:08 p.m. EST. I wanted to share some information from Musk about Starlink. It says, excited to announce that SpaceX Starlink has achieved break-even cash flow. Excellent work by a great team. Starlink is also now a majority of all active satellites and will have launched a majority of all satellites cumulatively from Earth by next year. SpaceX posted a picture with information about Falcon fairing recovery. They said SpaceX team aboard the recovery vessel dug in the Atlantic, securing a payload fairing half which has supported 13 missions to date after last night's Starlink launch from Florida. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. The groundwork continues at the suborbital test site. Work also continues on the wall around the suborbital test site. Preparations for further Star Factory expansion work is continuing. The work on expanding Star Factory is also continuing. The S24.2 test tank was seen lifted and moved at Massey's test site. As you will likely have seen since the last video, Starship 25 was restacked atop Booster 9 once again. SpaceX posted a drone video of the restacked Starship vehicle with information about the launch. They said the second flight test of a fully integrated Starship could launch as soon as mid-November pending regulatory approval. Chris Burgin posted an interesting video with some interesting information. He said, so there's a big net under Booster 9 on the orbital launch mount. That's new. At a later point, Starship 25 was yet again destacked from Booster 9. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.